To add a valve in Plant 3D, simply drag and drop the desired fitting from the dynamic tool palette. The fitting will automatically adjust its size based on the selected pipeline. Plant 3D determines the pipe size and places the appropriate valve accordingly. Here's a demonstration. We'll begin by opening the piping drawing and ensure we are working in parallel mode with dynamic input enabled. We want to add valves to the pump's discharge line. We start by selecting a check valve from the palette. After placing it, the valve automatically snaps to the pipe center, and we can position it where needed. Plant 3D will also add a flange to the valve placement. Next, we'll add a gate valve to the line. The system automatically places flanges, but we'll adjust the configuration to avoid unnecessary flanges and welds. By deleting the previous valve placements and selecting the check valve again, we place it directly on the pump's node. The gate valve is then placed on the check valve's node. This method results in fitting-to-fitting connections without extra flanges. For drain valves, we choose a threaded gate valve and place it at the end of a pipe stub. The system sizes the valve automatically, and we can adjust the valve's handwheel orientation. Next, we add plugs to the valve's ends, repeating the same process on the other side. To tag these valves, we can either assign a specific number if known, or let the system assign the next available tag. This can be done through the Assign Tag menu in the right-click options. After tagging the valves, we use AutoCAD's copy function to duplicate configurations, ensuring all components are correctly placed. By selecting a common point, we copy the setup to the corresponding point on the other side. You can see that while the configuration has been duplicated, it isn't connected yet. The teardrop symbol indicates that the piping isn't properly linked to the adjacent component. On the other hand, when you look at the working configuration, the transparency shows a gasket and the lollipop-shaped icon, indicating that bolts are present. This means the configuration is complete. Now that we've copied over the configuration, I'll highlight the valve and use the connect component to adjacent feature. By selecting the adjacent pump, the connection will automatically form. The lollipop, bolts, and gaskets will appear, confirming the connection is complete. The teardrop symbol will disappear as well. Next, I'll extend the piping run from the flange to the elbow without needing to duplicate the valve or piping. This saves time and modeling effort. Now, I'll quickly update the valve tags. After right-clicking and assigning the tag, you'll notice that the copied tag has a question mark. This happens because duplicate valve tags aren't allowed. In a real plant, you wouldn't find two valves with the same number. To fix this, I'll assign the next available tag, and the question mark will disappear. I'll move on to adding additional valves for practice. For example, on this exchanger, I'll drop a standard gate valve onto the pipe. Once it snaps into place, I'll use the rotation grip to adjust the valve's orientation. If I encounter any obstructions like grating, I can temporarily unload or freeze the layer to make it easier to place components without unnecessary snap points interfering. For the next valve, I'll drop a flange gate valve on the line, snapping it directly to the elbow. After tagging it, I'll move on to demonstrate the piping adjustments for a globe valve. If I need a 4-inch globe valve, I can change the pipe size and automatically place reducers to accommodate it. Once the piping is set, I'll place the globe valve and tag it appropriately. Finally, I'll review the model and make sure all components are tagged correctly. It's important to remember that if you're unsure about the tags, you can leave them with the question mark and update them later as needed.